how to make something glow with just 3 layers. Let's go.
In my last tutorial, I showed you how to make stamps, but now we're gonna make these puppies glow. First step, duplicate that layer and then go to the last layer. Next, you're gonna go to adjustment and go to Gaussian blur and just blur her up. Alrighty, now we're going to duplicate that layer. And with this layer, we're gonna make it lighter. Go to adjustments again and then go to hue and saturations. And then we're just going to brighten her up just a little bit. All right, now for the fun part, we are going to change this and then change it to add as well as this one. And there you go, an easy tutorial on how to make something glow.
Here's how to make an easy Procreate watercolor brush. First, you want to go and duplicate your blotchy brush, and then in that, you want to turn down the streamline, go to Apple Pencil, turn the pressure size to 0, and the properties, turn up the maximum size. Do at me if you make this brush.
This is how I create a seamless pattern in Procreate. Bear with me. So first, you're gonna start with your main pattern element. You're gonna add a layer on top of it and add a dark color to that new layer and turn the opacity down. Then you're gonna group these two layers together and duplicate it 4 more times. Don't worry, we will get rid of the color later. After you've duplicated it, you're gonna turn all of them off except for the second one, and you're gonna drag it to the corner until it lines up perfectly. The corner of your colored square should be touching the middle exactly. Now you're going to repeat this process with the other groups you made. There should be no seams within the red color. This is not what you want. This is what you want. So repeat it with all the other layers that you have. And when you're done, you can turn back on your first layer. And now you're going to go through and delete all the colored layers. We just used these as a guide to know that our lines were perfect. And now you can duplicate this pattern multiple times and it will be seen.
The first mistake the beginners make when drawing eyelashes is not flicking. Flicking prevents the lash from looking stubby. Second mistake is even spacing. You want the lashes to overlap. Number 3, the lash has to hook out of the eye. A lot of the times beginners just kind of make it straight out of the eye. I don't know how to explain it. It has to hook out of the eye to make it look more realistic, you know? You can practice by drawing over the image and filling the rest in. This can help you understand the direction of the lashes. On Procreate, I like to use studio pen with a low opacity to avoid harshness. If you're doing this traditional, make sure that your pencil is sharp. Repeat the same flicking motion throughout the entire process. Make sure that each eyelash looks like itself. Don't make it look like every other lash on there. It's just gonna look repetitive and boring. Remember that in the middle of the eye, the lashes are going towards you. The ones on the left are going to the left, and the ones on the right are going to the right. Simple, right? The bottom is pretty much the same too. Add some highlights for realism. And with enough practice, you'll get it down.
Here's a Procreate pro tip for drawing realistic hair. Sample the low lights, midtones, and highlights to create a quick palette, then turn the opacity down on the original image. Color block in the hair with a monoline brush, Then, using the fine hairbrush, smudge out the color blocks.
Ever get accidental strokes in your canvas like this? Here's a way to avoid that. Go to Actions, Gesture Controls, General, Disable Touch Action. Now if your fingers touch a canvas, it won't make a mark. Isn't that exciting? Here's a fast way to clear a layer of work you no longer want. Say you're working on a layer and you kind of hate it. To clear all, just take 3 fingers and swipe back and forth on the screen. For more Procreate tricks, check out my page.
Keep watching to learn how to make a shadow brush. The first thing you're going to do is create a black circle and duplicate it and move the second circle to wherever you want the shadow to be. Then you're going to turn it into alpha lock and change the color to a light gray. Once you did that, you're going to merge the layers together and try to center as much as possible. A trick to this is turning your drawing guide on the max size and line up the dots with the lines. Then you're going to change your background color to black and invert the colors of the dots by selecting it and selecting invert. Then you're going to save the image as a JPEG to your device. You're going to duplicate your favorite calligraphy pen or any pen at all. Then you're going to change the shape source and import the photo that we just created. Then you're going to go to rendering and change the rendering mode to light glaze, and you are pretty much done. Let me know any other tutorials that you want to see.